The federal government says money which would have gone to an Aboriginal medical service in Sydney will instead go to the New South Wales government. It comes as a health expert says government moves to defund the vital Aboriginal medical service will affect more than just physical health. Thousands have signed a petition to keep the service alive. Political reporter Myles Morgan reports.
The Aboriginal Medical Service, Western Sydney, received over $2 million in government money over the last year, but it's struggling to stay open. It's been told it'll be getting no more money because it has huge debts and it should begin transitioning patients to other services.
My understanding is that the entire debt is around a tax bill, not about any other kind of mismanagement. It's simply about a tax bill, which is, you know, something that I think we as a broader community need to talk about. If we expect services to be delivered, you can't chronically underfund them and expect them to perform miracles plus some.
The medical service says its debt problems were caused by circumstances out of its control. Professor Jackson Pulver says it's part of a larger problem.
We know it's been effectively closing the gap for some years now. To chronically underfund it and then go off and say it's their fault that we are closing it down, then I just don't think that's the right message.
So now over 10,000 Aboriginal patients in Sydney's West could be forced to attend non-specialist clinics. And for the right or wrong reasons, First Nations patients aren't just losing a medical service, they're losing a community cornerstone.
And it provides a very, very large community place for people to see strong Aboriginal people being health workers, being nurses, being doctors, being optometrists, being podiatrists, running things like, I don't know, diabetes services and well persons health checks and children's services.
An online petition has thousands of signatures supporting the AMSWS. Myles Morgan, NITV News.